a barefaced day, so that can only mean one thing, a makeup tutorial, but also a run through of my classic and new makeup must-haves that I think are worth putting on your Christmas wish list. Let's start with base and concealer. Most people who watch this know I am completely addicted to Arborian BB cream. This is Doré. I love it. It's just brilliant. Arborian are that perfect hybrid between skincare and makeup. That and the BB crayons. I use all three shades, are pretty much what I wear on my skin most days when I'm filming. So if you see me and you think her skin looks nice, generally that's what I'm wearing. I'm gonna stick it on my list. Obviously, it's not necessarily new, I just think it's brilliant. It does come in a limited range of shades, which is the only thing I can hold against it. Please, Arborian, create it in at least 25 shades. It's amazing. Everybody I know that tries it loves it. It sits above my favourite tinted moisturiser, which is the ridiculously expensive Chantecaille Just Skin, but I do like it. If you see me on a day off and I'm not filming in real life, this is what I'll be wearing. It's a light coverage, it's really nice. And then if I'm looking for something with a little bit more coverage, and I was shocked by how much coverage this is, I have recently fallen in love with the Dewdrop foundation. And it's got a little, it's really interesting actually. So it comes out and it's really, really runny and you think, well, this isn't gonna give much coverage, but it really packs a punch. In fact, I'm going to apply this one and I'm gonna show you what it's like. Let me just stick my hair back so that it doesn't get in my eyes while I'm doing this. There you go. Let me show you what it's like. So you push the button and you get a delivery and you think that's not going to go very far. It's obviously a serum foundation. It's super runny. First must have brush number one, IT Cosmetics, the dual ended one. But actually it's got quite a lot of coverage and I was really shocked when I used this. Sam Chapman raves about this foundation. And when you see Sam in real life, he always has the most natural skin. So I was really shocked at how much coverage this gave. And it is a real demi matte finish as well. You can see what goes on afterwards. You need a couple of pumps really for a really good coverage. Now I've got a lovely little spot there. My fault entirely. With a little blind spot, and guess what? I stuck a really strong salicylic acid on it and then attacked it, and now I've just got a hole in my face. It's a really demi matte grown-up finish. It's not something I would wear every day, but I wanted to give you the option of three different finishes for foundations. So you've got Just Skin, you've got BB cream, and then you've got the Dewdrop foundation. And interestingly enough, the Just Skin is the thickest formula. Then you have the BB cream, then you have the Just Skin, but in terms of coverage, it's the reverse. So there you go. You probably, for most skins, don't need a concealer, but let me introduce you to two of the concealers I love. Obviously, I absolutely love the Arborian BB cream. I'm gonna take the darkest shade, which is Doré for me. I'm just gonna dab it on that little blemish there. Let me show you around my eyes in the lighter shade here. And that's the secret of where you apply your concealer. When you get older, you don't put it in massive triangles under your eyes. However, I also want you to introduce you to my favorite concealer launch of this year, and it is Lancôme Teint Idole Ultra Wear. And this is a beautiful, almost mini foundation. It's very lightweight, very liquid. It blends beautifully. It's really lovely. And this absolutely could serve as a foundation for people that got good skin. You just wear it down the center panel and blend it out. But I'm gonna apply it around my nose and show you how beautifully it works. Really, really lovely. I definitely put, I mean, is it nice to put concealers and foundation on a wish list? I don't know, but these are the ones that I've fallen in love with this year for all different skin types and coverages. So let's start by just buffing that into that crater. Oh, how attractive. See how that Lancôme blends out almost like a foundation for a little bit of extra coverage on your nose. And then let me show you how this concealer blends out as well. So you basically don't move it around that much. It's just to counteract the dark circles around my eyes. So it's literally concealing darkness around my eyes. And then I go in with the larger end and just blend out. Gosh, that crater on my face is most attractive. And there you go, there's the base done. Sorry, I keep looking in there because that's my image and that's where you are. When it comes to powder, I haven't changed my mind. There hasn't been a single powder launched this year that is better than this. And it's Beauty Pie One Powder Wonder. It's completely white in the palette. I know what you're gonna think, that's really scary, but watch. Watch the magic of this. It's truly uberlucent, so it has zero color in it. It has a soft focus blurring effect. But it doesn't sit in your lines. Win, 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 win. There is a code Nadine sent me, and I think you get a £50 boosted spend for the first month, if it's still up. But trust me, I just love that product so much. There is nothing else like it on the market. I really love it. And even though it's compact and it's not loose, it goes on so lightly. It's the only powder I use. So base done. Really straightforward, simple, looks okay. Fairly heavy coverage in the middle, medium coverage and going out to nothing at the outside. Right, where are we going from here? Well, bronzers. And I have to say, most of the time I use Benefit Hoola. It's a really simple, easy, reasonably priced matte finish bronzer. I think all bronzers should be matte. But this year, Christian Dior launched just the most beautiful bronzer ever, and I love it. And here it is. It's the Christian Dior, Dior Forever Neutral Bronze. And it comes in a sort of faux leather padded gorgeousness. I absolutely love my Lady Dior. I used it till it fell apart. I really loved it. And this is like a little mini Lady Dior. And look at that. How gorgeous. I'm going to go in with the same brush, which I used just now, which is the Elizabeth Arden Mineral Finish Brush. It's for their mineral foundation. They use that. It comes in a box with that and a miniature version so that you can travel with it. It's just brilliant. There's nothing else like it on the market. It's completely synthetic. It's angled. I use it for all of my face bases. So all powders and all bronzers. Let me show you the Dior. I'm literally just going to go around the outside of my face, hide my turkey neck, little tip there. And it's just beautiful. It's super subtle, really lovely. It's a gorgeous shade. You could use it as an eyeshadow if you wanted to, down the centre of your face, across the top of your cheeks. It's just lovely, just warms your face up. Dior, the packaging is divine. I love it. Now on to cheek colour. I swear, by the way, that I'm allergic to makeup. Because every time I start making my face up, my nose runs. So I keep having to stop, wipe my nose and reapply concealer around my nose. That Dior concealer is amazing, but it's not rub worthy in the sense of rubbing around my nose. Nothing. I've never found a concealer that would stick there and stay there 24/7. If you know one, please tell me in the comments below. Right, let's talk about cheek colours. I have to say my favourite cheek colour this year, and it's an Anastasia Beverly Hills one. And I tell you why I absolutely love it. It's because it comes in a cream stick, but it's easy to blend out and has an inbuilt brush in it. So this is the Anastasia Stick Blush. And it's really beautiful. It's a great little shape. It has a little miniature stippling brush at one end, and at the other end you've got the colour. So let me show you it. And I do like stick blushes because I think they are, I mean, I like a cream blusher anyway. I think it's really nice for the party season. But what I love about it is it's easy to control where it goes. So you basically just do little dots here. And as usual, I've chosen that classic peachy colour, which I think suits most skins. This shade, by the way, is Peachy Keen. See, I do love a peachy colour. And then the brush just stipples it out. It's quite short, quite a stubby little brush. And you don't necessarily need to use it. You can use your normal brush. But I do think that's quite clever that that stipples that out really well. Because that's kind of the strength of the brush you need to move it around. There you go. How lovely is that? Let's do the other side. Now, I should have started this video with a disclaimer saying I am not a professional makeup artist. Obviously, you can see I'm not. But I think in a way that's quite nice that you've got a normal person doing a makeup tutorial with normal skin and all of its flaws rather than some sort of perfect youthful person looking gorgeous. I really like that colour. I really like that product, full stop. There you go. That's the Anastasia one. If you're going to go for a palette, though, the palette of the year was definitely the NARS Orgasm palette. I think it's still available in certain stores. I use Orgasm most days as my blush. It's a peachy, orangey colour with a slight shimmer to it. I don't mind a bit of shimmer on my face. And this was the Orgasm palette of this year. And it's just all kinds of divine. So if you're going to ask for a palette, go for it. There's the NARS Orgasm palette of this year. So there's Orgasm. And then you've got in here Turtle Bay, Montezuma, Orgasm, Naples, Mandalay and Zuma. So technically that is all you need. You could easily do your eyes with that as well. So if I just show you Orgasm on top of this, let's use a Real Techniques brush. You'll see it's a really similar colour. If you layer a powder over a cream, it will make it last longer as well. My eyebrow back up where it belongs. There you go. I just think it's such a youthful place to wear a little bit of shimmer and a peach. I really like it. Anyway, so that was the NARS Orgasm On The Beach palette, so which means it was a summer launch, but it's still available. If you're going to buy a blusher, either buy the individual NARS Orgasm. It's just the most beautiful blusher, suits all skin types, all skin tones, all skin ages, has just the right amount of light reflective particles in it, a sort of very, very, very soft shimmer, but is just super flattering. And that, if you can get any of the Orgasm palettes, go for it. Where do we go next? Let's go on to eyes and a few things. I've got a couple of palettes, and I'm not generally a fan of palettes because for me, palettes, you tend to use two or three shadows from them and then you don't use the rest. But I'm going to give a shout out to two palettes that were launched this year. The first is the Charlotte Tilbury Super Nudes. And I tell you why, because it's a mini palette and I do love a mini palette. I also think palettes make nice Christmas gifts. If somebody's going to dip their toe into eyeshadow and they don't know where to go, this is a great place to start. And you couldn't get a better neutral palette than that. That's everything I could possibly need on my eyes forever, essentially. So that is the Super Nudes eye palette from Charlotte Tilbury. And I think if you're buying for a fairly conservative, classic makeup person, that's the palette to get them. So we'll put that to one side and I'll show you the Vavavoom palette of choice for this year. Splash out, or you've got young people in your family and they're absolutely obsessed with Jamie Genevieve. This palette is amazing. This is the Vive Muse palette. And it's all kinds of stunning, I have to say. I'm going to go on to mention what I use from Jamie Genevieve in a minute, which is much more straightforward. But you can't go wrong with this palette. Look how beautiful it is. And it's basically inspired by, it's a cooler tone palette, but it's inspired by her love of all things. Let me take that protective cover off. Her love of all things sort of slightly Roxy Music-ish. It's very Studio 54. And I think that is an absolutely gorgeous palette to put on anybody's wish list if they really love it. It's got some great colours in it. It's more of a kind of heathery tone, golden tone than I would usually wear. But I think those two palettes are absolutely lovely. And the colour payoff on that is really nice. The Charlotte Tilbury colour payoff is not that great. But I kind of like that because I like the fact that you can build it up. Jamie Genevieve's gone for a medium payoff colour pigment, which I quite like. But you can have fun with it. I mean, she's got all the tutorials in the world. She's such a nice person. I really want to support this brand. I really like her. I think she's really down to earth. I love that she starts from a no makeup perspective. But what I've been using and loving are the Vive eye wands. And this is what I've been wearing mostly. This is, my colour is Hazelnut. And let me show it to you on the back of my hand, but I will apply it. And it's one of those gorgeous sort of blendable cream eyeshadow crayons. But rather than it being a sharpener one, it's a roll-up one. And then I've got another one here. They're all really nice shades, by the way. And this is Camel. And this is slightly lighter and warmer. These are amazing. Let me show you how they work. Now, bearing in mind, I've got crepey eyes. It's not easy to blend on. They are so soft and easy to blend. This is the grown-up version of the eye palette for the cosmetics conservative. So, you know, you don't want anybody looking at you going, wow, nice makeup. You just want somebody to go, oh, you look nice. Let me show you how it works. And also let me show you how I knock back my hooded crepey eyelids. So what you do is you apply it literally just in the crease there, and then a little bit underneath, and it's so soft, it applies really well. I'm going to do one eye in one shade and one eye in the other shade so you can have a look. Obviously, you can go down onto the lid. The important thing is you get it into that shape. Now, that is the lighter shade. So that is Camel. However, for a party, I prefer the darker shade. And this is what I've been wearing a lot of recently. This is Hazelnut. This is much more intensely pigmented and it's a slightly cooler brown. You see, when you see a makeup being applied to a wrinkly eyelid, you see what it's like. So this is the darker shade, and then underneath, there you go. Now, that looks like a child's applied it, right? Then you blend it out. And to blend it out, I'm going to use my Real Techniques brush. I'm going back in. This is brush 200, which is the blending brush, right? So let's start with the lighter shade. And basically, you just do the classic Charlotte Tilbury back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. I tend to go more inwards because the area I want to shade is here rather than out here. But that's how soft they are and easy to blend. Super easy, super soft. There's a slightly smaller brush here for blending. This is Real Techniques 201, and that's good for under the eye there. And then what I do is I go in with my Beauty Pie, One Powder Wonder again. I take the Hourglass brush, which is actually their concealer brush, but I absolutely love it for slightly larger areas. And then what I do is I go back round here to clear this area, under the eye there. And somebody the other day said to me, oh, I really like your highlighting eyeshadow. I said, I don't have a highlighting shadow. Well, what I've got is Beauty Pie One Powder Wonder. There you go. So that's the lighter version. Let me go back in and blend out the darker one and show you what that looks like. I can't tell you how nice these shadow sticks are from Vive. They're really beautiful. And they really stay put. They blend really easily. I mean, look how easy that is to create a smoky eye. Pulling a face just to blend out underneath. And then going back in, just cleaning up that area that you don't want any shadow. So in the outer corner there. So there you go. That's the darker shade and that's the lighter shade. And I'm actually going to go in and I'm going to go back in with that darker shade because it is the shade I really love. Eyebrows next. And as you can see, my eyebrows are fairly sparse. To this day, I still cannot find a better eyebrow wand than this. And this is Legends by Charlotte Tilbury. I do like the L'Oreal Plump and Set Brow. It's really good if you're on a budget. But this I love because it's a tiny spoolie. And the smaller the spoolie, the more control you have. If you have really large brows, good for you. I'm very jealous. You can use a chunky spoolie. If not, you need a small spoolie for control. And you just go through your brows. And it's got just enough staying power to hold them up, but without. And I always go back and forth at the ends because that's where I've got the hairs missing. Without them drying sort of disgustingly sticky. There you go. Brow done, brow not done. So easy to do. And it has got slight fibers in it, but it's super subtle, it really is. Back and forth, where the hairs are missing. And it doesn't make my eyebrows sort of Instagram worthy, but it does make them, it does make them defined and much more face framing, I think. So there you go. That is definition and brows. I'm still going to go back to my absolute classic. I mean, nothing ever, 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 ever will beat a MAC eyeliner. It just won't. I'm sorry. Teddy is an eye coal. And it's a softer shade, but it's the one that lovely Dom, if you ever go onto my Instagram and you look at the lives I do with Dom, he's just amazing. I adore him. He's the one that got me addicted to this. So basically you go on the waterline and then I flick it out at the edges. Look at the difference, just the waterline's made there. Under the waterline and out at the edges. And then I pull my eye out. Sorry, skin sin, I know, but once you get to my age and you've got crepey eyelids, it's the only way not to get that juddery line. and I go back and forth just in the base of the lashes. And that's the look you'll get. Look at the difference, even though that has already been tight lined. I don't know what I'd do without my eyeliners. I absolutely love them, and Teddy is probably my all-time favourite. And then I just do a little kind of with what's left over like that. There's simply nothing better. Nothing will beat that, I promise you. And then what I tend to do is go over the top with this and a very dark eyeshadow. And until recently, obviously, I was using my Black Plum from Bobbi Brown, but it's been discontinued. So let's go in with the Charlotte Tilbury. You just need an almost black brown defining one. So I'm going to go in with that black there on the end. And it just, what it does is it basically sets it really in at the base of the lashes. I'm not looking to lose any of my tiny space I've got here, so I don't want a really thick line, but it just sort of sets it. There you go. Gets harder and harder to make up your eyes the older you get, trust me, because the skin becomes crepier and crepier. Onto mascara, obviously, to finish the look. And I repeat, nothing is better than Charlotte Tilbury push-up lashes. I absolutely love it. It's really, really clever. And generally, until this point, until she launched this, I was not a fan of her mascaras. I thought they overloaded the brushes really badly. But this is very clever. It's a flat comb brush mascara that literally lifts your lashes, because the action of using it and pushing against it pushes your lashes up. Let me show you. And you can build it up. It's a flexible bristle rubber comb. So it's a cross between a comb mascara and a brush mascara. And I just love the fact that you're in control. You can build it up slowly. Sorry, somebody was at the door. It's interesting, isn't it, that Charlotte Tilbury is famous for certain things. And I actually think the things I love most about her range are not the things she's famous for. So I love this mascara. I love the legendary brows. I love the cryo recovery mask. I should be using that on Monday morning when a car comes to pick me up at 8 o'clock. There you go. Second coat. I feel like it puts you in control of where you put it. Yes, it does have a tendency to slightly overload the brush. Stroke comb, but I do love a stripper lash, so I don't have a problem with that. And there you go, round defined eyes. Nothing groundbreaking, nothing exciting, but hey, I want to look healthy and happy and well defined. I don't want to look like I'm going to break makeup boundaries. That's not what I'm about at my age. Finally, onto lips. I want to talk about two things that were launched this year that I absolutely love. The first one is this, and it's the Bobbi Brown Crushed Jelly Lip. I'll put the details below, in honey. I absolutely love it, and I've used it most days. Let me show it to you. It's that perfect nude brown lip. It's a hybrid sort of stain balm lip colour. I really like it. Let me take that off, because it's more of a day look. And then also, I absolutely love the MAC Love Me Liquid Lip Colours. They're beautiful. I did not expect to love them, and I absolutely love them. And my go-to colour is Laissez-Faire, and let me show you this. So this is a classic matte liquid lipstick. And normally they're dry and tight and unpleasant. I just love these products. This feels like you've got nothing on your lips. It's really, really, really lightly fragranced. But the fragrance disappears quite quickly. You can taste it slightly in your mouth. That to me is the best liquid matte lipstick launch of the year. So you've got a balm lipstick from Bobbi Brown and that from MAC. And can I at this point give a shout out to things that I would want in my Christmas wish list? And that is, have you seen the MAC Christmas collection? Tiny Tricks with Mini Lipstick Trio in Neutral. It's just gorgeous. Look at that. three miniature lipsticks in the most beautiful neutral shades. I mean, obviously I'm a neutral lip girl. They do come in reds as well. I mean, that is just lovely. I would want that in my Christmas stocking, and I get sent so much stuff. And absolutely 100% out of all the MAC stuff, and they've got the most beautiful collection of Christmas gifts this year. I absolutely love this. Oh, look at that. And they are miniatures, but they're good size miniatures. And then the flacon on the outside, the bullet, matches the colour inside. And I would probably wear all those shades. I mean, I just absolutely love that. I just think that's just stunning. I think MAC this year I've put that back incorrectly. MAC have absolutely knocked it out of the park this year. How do I get that back so those MACs line up? There you go, I think. Yes, there you go. Duh! That was like a beauty editor's Rubik's Cube. But for doofuses like me, I absolutely love that. I think that is probably my favourite lip kit for Christmas. I just absolutely love it. It's the Ultimate Trick Mini Lipstick 12 Vault. So it's got 12 absolute classic colours from the vault, and they're beautiful. I love that. And then finally, just a really quick shout out to the Charlotte Tilbury Super Nudes that she launched this year as well. They're absolutely beautiful. I love a nude lip. I know I'm biased. If you love a red lip, I'm sorry. Fast forward over this. But I just think the Super Nudes this year were gorgeous, and they were super nude. I mean, look at this. If you love that sort of beigey colour, though, it came in a range of shades and I just absolutely love them. So I've got here Super Fabulous, Super Model, Cover Star. I mean, I just think they were the nude lipstick launches of the year. Charlotte does a matte creamy lipstick really well, a classic matte creamy lipstick really well. There you go. Can you take my hair down? And that's the finished look. Obviously my hair needs re-blow drying now. It's a easy to create, easy to wear, well blended out, neutral, but slightly defined makeup look. And for me, it's my classic look. It's my classic look for a night out. I'm going to drop in the details of the brushes below, because I realise I didn't credit that NARS. That's the NARS smudging brush, which is just, there's really not a lot else on the market that's like it. It's absolutely brilliant. And it often sells out, especially if I mention it and then it comes back in again. If you want to smudge out an idiot-proof eyeliner, and you saw that it took me a matter of seconds to blend that eyeshadow and that eyeliner. I get that professional makeup artists are incredible and they can blend out their makeup for hours on end. That's not me. If I wasn't filming this, it would be 5 or 6 minutes and I'd be out. And then I wouldn't really want to reapply it during the day. I want this to last all day. The only thing I'd take with me would be the Beauty Pie One Powder Wonder, probably the dual-ended brush, and then my lipstick, and then that would be it. That is my Christmas, if you've been a good girl, that is my Christmas wish list makeup and makeup tutorial for an absolutely classic party look. It's just an amped up version of my everyday look. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. I'll put all the details down below. Next week, how about we do wishlist skincare? This is the sort of in my dreams, money's no object. This is what I'd like to find in my skincare stocking on Christmas Day. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. I'll put all the details of all the products down below. You tell me what you want me to create in the new year as well. Should we do the best buys of 2021? And I'll try and get Joe on and we'll do some filming together. She's been having a bit of a rough time with Arthur recently because he's had all these jabs and he's not sleeping properly. But as soon as she's got the energy and effort, we'll create some.